Fernandez against Okazaki. This fight is brought to you by Winning More Fun in the Philippines. Fernandez in the black trunks, Okazaki in the yellow and black. The interim bantamweight world championship belt on the line. So fast on his feet, Bibiano.
Bibiano's just stalking right now and looking for that takedown, just like that.
So strong, he's throwing Okazaki about like a bit of a rag doll there.
This is a dangerous position for Koetsu Okazaki to be in, having one of the top grapplers in the world at his weight class on top of him. Bibiano's very, very comfortable in this position and knows how to finish.
Got a haunting face, Okazaki. But it'll take more than that to stop this man from Brazil.
You hear the corner of Bibiano telling him to pass and do some strikes, and Bibiano passes. Okazaka's working his butterfly guard a little bit there. Nice, right into mount. And now into back control. This could be danger for Koetsu Okazaki. Bibiano's very, very well versed at that rear naked choke. Danger already in the first 2 minutes.
Well, he had the presence of mind to send in a punch behind his head, but it's not gonna do a great deal. Not just one of them, anyway. He has Bibby's right arm tied up, but it's the left arm that could pose the threat, and that's why Okazaki's left arm is up there protecting the neck.
Uh-oh, Bibby's got his arm under the throat of Osaka.
May not last long.
This is going to be it. That's too deep. That's too deep. He's going to be able to get the choke. You see Osaka's fighting it. Yeah, Koetsu's really trying to fight this choke here, but Bibi has it really deep underneath the chin.
He's doing a great job, isn't he, in holding out, but he's not really achieving much.
This is going to be it.
He may well pass out without tapping.
Japanese fighters, very difficult to finish, but Bibi knows that he just needs to hold that and squeeze. Hold that choke and squeeze. And it's going to be a very, very long night for Koetsu Okazaki.
Well, full credit to him. He seems to be over the worst of it, doesn't he?
Great heart. What we talked about before, Japanese fighters are very difficult to finish. They really do have that warrior spirit when they fight.
You certainly called that right. That was a tough, tough going, and he pulled through it.
Well, Bibiano has about a minute and a half here to work in the first round to look for the submission. Submission or not, I've got to say that he's come closer to finishing the fight, gotten the takedowns, and he's going to be ahead on the scorecards thus far. Okazaki needs to turn and face Bibi here. You do not want a high-level BJJ black belt on your back in the first few minutes of a fight.
Well, he's had four minutes of that kind of pressure already, Okazaki, and there's another minute to go. Throat is not under any pressure now, but some punches are coming in from Fernandez. Half a minute left in this opening round. You can see on Okazaki's face the torture he's under and has been under. Fernandez is so relaxed that he's talking to his corner men.
Well, Fernandez is in a very dominant position. When you're on someone's back, there's not a whole lot you have to worry about. You can kind of just pick your shots and pick how you want to set up submission attempts. First round looks like it's in the books for Bibi.
Four more to come, Jason. This being a championship contest, it could be a long night for one of these men.
Bibiano here with a nice leg trip. Keeps good pressure on Koetsu Okazaki. Gets them to the mat and was able to finagle his way to the back here.
He finagled
all the way to the back. And that choke was deep. You see on Kotetsu's face the agony he's in there.
How did he withstand that? That's just guts, isn't it?
Guts and a lot of tenacity. Lots more MMA to come.
Seconds out, please.
Round two. From the first, where he was under pressure for the greater part of it. Backing off there until he couldn't back off any further. But I thought perhaps he might have had a threatening hold of Bibiano's head. Wasn't to be.
If you like our rambles and rants here, you should follow both Steve and I on Twitter. Myself at @followMMA and Steve at
Gul Asahi, G-U-L-A-S-A-H-I. Brief stop in the action here as referee Kenichi Sirizawa gives his countryman, Okazaki, a brief timeout to recover.
You get up to 5 minutes to recover, but obviously Koetsu did not need that. And Bibiano, I think here, is probably just gonna go back in on those punches, setting up the takedown. If it ain't baroque, don't fix it.
Good right hand to Bibiano's body from the Japanese fighter. And there it is again, it's a nice shot. More of that work could put him in a very good place. Bibiano, for the first time in this contest, I was gonna say, looks under a little bit of pressure, but he grabs hold of that leg and turns it around.
Right to the back again, Bibi like a spider climbing the wall.
Okazaki grabbing the cage, which you cannot do, and he's berated by the referee.
The human backpack, Bibiano Fernandes. What's in your bag, baby? A choke. As Bibi works his left hand over the top. And you know, this is just as tiring for Bibi to be holding on with his leg muscles. You see there, he lets go, as it is for Okazaki to be riding Bibi's weight. Again, all the pressure really on Bibiano Fernandes. He's the dream champion. Okazaki's coming in, getting a crack right out of the gate.
Nothing
the
to lose,
title.
I guess.
No, you just throw caution to the wind, and sometimes guys perform the best there when they have no pressure.
Well, nothing to lose except your arm, perhaps.
Arm, a limb here and there, a few stitches.
That right hand to the body is very impressive from Koetsu Okazaki. Limited damage that it does. And I always feel that a right to the body somewhat exposes your head. He's executed it well, though.
Brazil versus Japan, it's a matchup we've seen a million times in mixed martial arts, probably one of the oldest ones out there, dating back to.
Nice 1-2.
Gracie's in Brazil versus some of the Japanese guys that came down in the 40s and 50s. Enzo Gracie versus Sakuraba, another big Japan versus Brazil match. And Bibiano Fernandes, Koetsu Okazaki.
We're
here
seeing
in 1FC.
Plenty of reasons, Jason, as to why Okazaki was thought of well enough to take on Fernandes, because he's doing good work with his hands when they're standing up. It's in this position where he could find himself in a bit of trouble.
Bibiano back on top, working that methodical ground and pound. There's one thing that Bibiano does very well is execute his strategy. Set up the punches to get the takedown. Once you get that takedown, he's good with the ground and pound and knows how to advance the position and look for the submissions. Bibi just punished his guys on the ground too.
Okazaki wrapping those legs around Fernandez's body, locking it in at the ankle.
And Bibiano's won his last five fights. Actually won 12 of his last 13 fights. This is a difficult fight for Koetsu because what Bibi does well negates a lot of Okazaki's offense.
The heel is about all he could do in that position. Plenty of fighters opt to take that scenario, though. Keeping Fernandez at a distance, and that'll do the trick for the remainder of this round. Two rounds are in the book, and there are three more to go. Third round, then, potentially 15 more minutes of this contest. You start every round on your feet, and that's where his hope comes from.
Bibi controlling the middle of the cage here. Methodical in his movement. Okazaki looking for some angles, sprawls.
He seemed very nervous in that exchange. Okazaki, not at all surprised. I certainly don't blame him. Fernandez is so compact and strong looking.
And Bibi's doing a good job of just keeping that pace going and chasing Okazaki down all over the cage here. Okazaki's gotten a few good counter strikes in. Again, this is gonna be five-minute rounds. Interim belt on the line. Bibi with another nice takedown. And Bibi moves right into the mount position. This is a dangerous position for Okazaki to be in here. Five-time Pan Am champion, high-level Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt in one of the most dominating positions you can be in mixed martial arts or Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, the mount. Not sure I agree with turning your back to Bibi. Bibiano's gonna look to work in his figure four anaconda body lock here again with his feet as he simultaneously attacks the throat. An arsenal of offensive moves at the disposal of Bibiano Fernandez. Action's right here in front of us. And then some nice heel kicks, just loosening up the position a little bit, trying to force Okazaki to move.
2 minutes and 15 seconds left of this third round.
Conditioning really starting to play a factor now as we get a little past the halfway mark of this fight.
Fernandez with his back to the canvas then.
Oh, Bibi's looking to move into mount position here. Very dominant on the ground this far. On the back again. Koetsu Okazaki. Some elbows to the shoulder. Okazaki really just needs to make something happen here. He can't just sit while Bibi's working.
Entering the final minute of this round.
Short punches from the back. Koetsu moves into guard position. That's a little bit better.
Good, wow. Just avoided a heel to the face there, but almost had to deal with it again. A little bit of ground and pound now.
We haven't seen Bibi have to work much off of his back. This is going to be interesting to see what Bibiano Fernandez brings to the table in terms of guard work. Eats a right hand on the way up.
Oh, good left. The right hand missed, but the left hand was spot on from Okazaki. Oh, Okazaki there with a good right hand, but he took a kick in reply. That's three rounds in the book.
15 minutes down, 10 more minutes to go, and you know, so far, Bibiano Fernandez has really dominated the grappling portion. Was on the back of Okazaki for most of that time on the ground, and then was able to move into mount. Hasn't been able to lock in any submissions, but was able to get some good punishing shots in. Last couple of minutes there, Koetsu Okazaki was able to reverse and get on top and get back some of that ground and pound action, but I don't know if that's gonna be enough in the judges' eyes to put him ahead on the scorecards. Question remains, where do we go from here?
Yes. How many rounds?
You have two more, all right?
Seconds out. Seconds out, please. Seconds out.
So, two world champions from different organizations contesting the ONE FC interim world championship belt in the bantamweight division. Okazaki has asked for a timeout.
You can't ask for a timeout. Sadly, it looks like I think he just didn't have his mouth.
Didn't have his mouthpiece in, yeah.
That'd be great if you could ask for a timeout in MMA at any point.
Well, he did get one.
That's right. That's true. He was allowed the timeout. Hang on a second. I need to check something. All right, no problem. And Bibiano has some great training partners at AMC Pancake. He has a UFC champion, Demetrius Johnson, to get working with. Demetrius, one of the best guys in the world, fastest at his weight class by far. And you know, we talk about it all the time. Your training partners really can make or break how you do in the cage. There's an old saying, nice takedown by Bibi. There's an old saying that champions aren't made in the cage, they're just recognized there.
Like
train
that.
Hard, fight easy.
One of the things he perhaps has been schooled in, but I imagine there's a good degree of natural talent there as well, is the way he moves on his feet. He doesn't give his opponent a chance to get any space. He tracks him down. Puts his opponent just in the spot he wants him before he attacks.
Bibiano's on top, staying just busy enough so they don't stand this up here.
Busy is about all it is, though. He's really just tapping with that right hand.
Moves into mount. Very dominant position now. You know, if Bibiano can create space and use his hands to push on the face of Koetsu, sit up, he's going to be able to have a lot of leverage to throw punches and elbows. I find that a poor decision for Koetsu to keep turning his back to Bibiano Fernandes. Well, you know, he spent several minutes with his back to Bibiano, and Bibiano wasn't able to submit him, so maybe he feels like it's a better move for him to expose his back and defend the submission than it is for Bibi to be on top and rain down those punches. But that's one of the first things they teach you in jiu-jitsu is don't give your back to your opponent.
Okazaki has his right hand on Bibi's right hand there to prevent the arm going to the throat, but now it's a left-armed attack. And now he could be in trouble. No, it's still.
Well, Bibiano's just methodically working from the back here. He spent several minutes on the back of Okazaki, unsuccessful in the submission attempts, but was able to get his arm in pretty deep. And if he can get that arm in deep again, Koetsu may not have enough stamina to resist it like he did in the first round.
Spending all this time just defending and defending the submission.
You know, jiu-jitsu really is like building a house. You gotta have a strong base before you start worrying about, you know, where are these extra architectural pieces gonna come in. You gotta have good solid wrestling, good solid sweeps, base, position, balance. And you can see Bibby's just looking for his shots. Where should I put a window? Where should I put a skylight? Right here on a dome, I think.
Talking to the corner again, wasn't he there? I think he was asking how much time was left to see how much time he's got to build that house and what he can achieve in the 90 seconds that remained at that point.
Looks like he may move in on an armbar here. And again, Koetsu reverses. Bibby misses that.
Directly above us here at cage side.
Well, Koetsu has definitely given more problems for Bibi than we had initially expected coming into this fight. Very solid defensive skills, very well seasoned fighter.
Oh, good right hand from Bibi as he came in to counter the left kick from Okazaki.
Good right to the body.
Big right hand from Bibi. And it gets Okazaki backing off, but he says, come on, follow me. I'm sure he will.
Well, at least for the next 15
seconds.
Oh, that
was another good right hand. And again, he's backing off. And now Bibi's lighting the place up. And they're standing too. It's become a bit of a chase. Well, I'd say it's tough to see it any other way than Bibiano ahead, Jason.
I agree. Up to this point, I think that Bibiano's ahead. He had some great takedowns, like we saw there from Bibi, where he moved into mount afterwards, and we see here. Nice overhand right that landed right on the button.
Final round.
The fifth and final round of the interim bantamweight championship of ONE FC. And typically, they embrace in the center of the cage before mixing it up.
Maybe again. Right back into pushing the pace. Double underhooks. I think I just heard Arukit from Street Fighter. Not sure if that's an actual word or not, but you know, whatever motivates you, I guess, right?
Oh, well, he was nearly motivated there, Bibi, into a big right hand that almost connected. It may even have brushed the chin of Okazaki, but no more than that. That was a good right from Okazaki. And if he could have applied himself in that direction slightly more, we might be telling a bit of a different story in this one.
as it is. 3¾ minutes left for Okazaki to make a difference, which to my mind is badly needed. At this point, if you're the corner of Okazaki, you have to be telling him that, look, you've lost the fight to this point. You have to just throw caution to the wind and get in there and just get in the slugfest. You've got to bait Bibiano into just throwing punches. You know he's going to shoot or clinch off of that. Throw hands, look for the knee, throw hands, look for the knee.
And yet we heard Bibby's corner telling him you can knock him out.
Well, I think that that's very accurate. But look, in on a front guillotine choke there, but Koetsu misses it and puts Bibby on top with 3 minutes left.
Just brushed off a heel to the head there, Bibiano, as if he was wiping a bit of perspiration from his chin. Oh!
Looking at a couple of ankle locks here, but you know, Bibiano has already fought the ankle lock king in Aminari, and Aminari couldn't put him away, and I think Aminari is the best person in the world in ankle locks. I mean, he just dives on him. He has GPS for ankles. Bibiano knows exactly how he needs to move to be out of danger.
Bibby just twisted out of that potential ankle lock hold effortlessly to the oohs and ahs of the crowd here.
Right into mount again. Bibiano moves with 2 minutes left. This is not a good position for Okazaki to be in. Bibiano can just ride out the round, and Okazaki's going to turn his back again. I think Bibiano's won this fight. It's just a matter of will he finish the fight at this point.
Well, we've seen this before, haven't we? And you have to say that Okazaki's submission defense has been good enough against one of the best bantamweights in the world. That's undisputed. For 25 minutes, he's failed to be submitted.
Yeah, you can't really understand the tenacity and the adrenaline and the athletic conditioning it takes to fight 25 minutes. Oh, Bibiani's got the rear naked choke in now, looking to finish with a minute left. That's in deep. Ah, Okazaki doing a very good job of defending those chokes. I think Bibiano spent more time on Okazaki's back than he did on the flight here.
He turns around, perhaps a little bit of ground and pound in the last 50 seconds of this contest. That alone would not be enough. Instead, it's Bibby throwing the punches up and amazingly getting out of the way of that downward punch from Okazaki.
Well, Okazaki's reversed the back position a couple of times, but I don't really feel like he's done enough in the eyes of the judges to get the win.
Well, it could be that this fight now ends with the fighters on their feet, which is where Okazaki would probably have wanted the entire contest to have been, but that's not the way it happened. Last 10 seconds, and surely now, Bibiano, the Flash Fernandez, has maneuvered his way into a position where the interim world bantamweight championship belt gets put around his waist. There he is, doing push-ups in the cage. Yeah, I've done 25 minutes. Give me another 25, I think is the message there.
It was a great fight, and you saw that the closest we saw to a finish by Okazaki was that jumping to guard guillotine attempt he missed, and then he looked for a couple of ankle locks here, but Bibiano just really knows his way around the mat, steps over it, later on moves to that back position that we've seen him in so many times, almost had the rear naked choke, but Okazaki was able to reverse position on him and get back into guard. I have to think that Bibiano is going to take this, even though Okazaki put up a great fight. We'll see.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. And all three judges see it for your winner via unanimous decision and the 1FC interim bantamweight world champion from the red corner, Bibiano, the Flag.